Hello, guys and gals, me Mudahar, and today we're going to be talking about how a scumbag on YouTube got scammed. Ladies and gentlemen, you might remember BitBoy Crypto or Ben Armstrong. But before I get into this guy real quick, I got to explain to you the world we're about to dip into. The rabbit hole we're looking at is crypto YouTube, ladies and gentlemen. A part of YouTube filled with pseudo-finance gurus, the worst financial advice you can find. And ladies and gentlemen, if you ever wanted to know the top crappy tokens to buy and lose your money, it's these scumbags that you can ask. It's literally a group of content creators that really seem like they're not exploding, you know, the algorithm or anything. Most people don't know of these people, but unless you're in the finance world, unless you're looking into like crypto shenanigans, some of these names will pop up, and from time and time again, they'll constantly be promoting a terrible coin, sometimes saying that it'll get 10x or 100x or some insane amount on your investment. And generally in these channels, what they'll always tell you is, these are videos for entertainment only. It's not financial advice. Now, ladies and gentlemen, financial advice is something you should be very careful on providing on the internet. I never provide financial advice. You want to know why? It's because I am not a financial advisor. And even if I was a financial advisor, I would never give out financial advice for free, okay? If you ever want to get rich, you don't get rich quick. You get rich slow and low. Ladies and gentlemen, you make some money, you invest it wisely into safe investments, or if anything, the best advice is to talk to a finance manager, a finance expert. Not somebody on YouTube, not somebody selling you a $50 course, and not somebody who's shilling crypto. On average, these videos are some of the most poorest quality, some of the lowest research videos that you'll ever find on the internet. And generally, it's always some douchebag in their car recording what they think is going to explode to the moon. Hey guys, it's me, Crypto Bob here, ladies and gentlemen. I'm going to tell you right now, one of the best altcoins is Cuckcoin right now. I'm telling you, boys, you just buy it, you sit in the corner, you sit in a little chair and you watch it, and then you just watch it go 10x, 100x. Ladies and gentlemen, I swear to God, this won't go 99% to the bottom of the earth. You know, it's not that I made a bag or anything. I clearly, you know, it's not that I made any advertising, you know, promotion money, but you guys should put money into Cuckcoin, dude. You sit in the corner, you watch, you know, it's a bull market, boys. You sit there, you watch the bulls go at it. But ladies and gentlemen, you know, Cuckcoin, it's the future. Anyways, Crypto Bob, done chilling. I'm out, boys. Got to go to the Lambo dealership. Now, if you look at Ben's channel, nowadays, it's called Discover Crypto, ladies and gentlemen. And of course, they feed the same bullshit like huge pumps incoming, will it moon, next 100x, huge gains. Ladies and gentlemen, bullshit faux financial advice that one should not follow. A year ago, Ben used to actually be on this, okay? February 27th, 2023, according to the Wayback Machine, you used to see Ben's face, Freedom Through Crypto, BitBoy Crypto, and he would promote the same BS. And ladies and gentlemen, the brand will not work with him anymore, okay? They've actually removed him because they had to assist Ben in his, you know, issues with substance abuse. Ben relapsed, and they actually claimed Ben had inflicted emotional, physical, financial damage on hit employees and others in the space. It's kind of like if I got kicked off of Some Ordinary Gamers. Like, could you imagine me being replaced by somebody else? I don't know. I thought Ben owned his channel, but not really. It seems like Ben was part of a hit network or a actual parent company known as BJ Investment Holdings, and they all cumulatively came to the idea that we should kick Ben off of the channel. And of course, if it was substance abuse, Ben decided to come back hardcore and actually bring up some facts of the matter, okay? This is a drug test posted by @joinbencoin. What is Bencoin, you may ask? We'll get into that in a bit. But here, I'll take things that never happened for 500, where Ben Armstrong actually posts a test result of their drug history. So you can see here that Ben is, you know, negative results on cocaine, marijuana, opiates, PCP, amphetamines, and heroin. Now, of course, you know, I've looked at Ben, and I can actually probably side with him and say he doesn't give me the look of somebody that's on cocaine. But ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to leave that for the lawyers to argue about. Maybe Ben was on stuff. Maybe Ben was abusing stuff. Maybe he wasn't. I don't know. Ben is an unreliable narrator. Now, because of this, Ben has basically went into e-begging, okay? Ben is apparently building up legal funds, and he started to beg for money on the internet. Now, personally, Ben, who's a self-admitted millionaire, flexed a Lamborghini, actually showcased a Rolex watch that some people believe is valued at $350,000. Don't know where they got that figure from. But ladies and gentlemen, Ben is not hurting for cash. Seems like he has a nice house. Get a job, sell your assets. E-begging is like the lowest form, dog. How can you claim that you're rich and also beg for money? But the reason why I'm laughing at Ben's misfortunes is that he is a truly full-on psychopathic scumbag on YouTube. And the fact that he actually had a channel and it stayed up that long is actually a showcase of YouTube's ignorance or severe benevolence. So let's actually look at his history. Now, if Ben's name sounds familiar, it's because Ben was involved with suing another fellow YouTuber known as Atozi. Atozi is a fellow commentary channel, friend of the channel, and somebody who made a video on Ben criticizing him. This video is called "This YouTuber Scams His Fans, Bitboy Crypto." Now in this video, Atozi looks into one of the many promotions Ben does on his channel, and at the time, one of them was called Pamp Token, okay? So we're gonna listen to some of Bitboy's own words and come to the idea of what his advice truly sounds like.
I told you there's a project guaranteed to increase in price.
Whoa, a project guaranteed to increase in price? Wow, anybody that tells you that there's gonna be a guaranteed increase on something is lying to you. How do you predict that? How do you have any metrics? All right, let's listen to our buddy Ben here.
I know you would probably want to jump in, but I'm sure the first thought you would have would be, wait a second, that doesn't sound right. Well, this is where we get into the complicated gray areas of decentralized finance.
Yeah, you know, Ben, it does sound too good to be true, all right? Come on now. Now, ladies and gentlemen, when Ben promoted Pamp Token, you could look at the price chart over here. You could see that during the time of the promotion, it seems, there was a high volume, which means that money was being traded, coins were being switched around. The value went up, and of course, Pamp fell straight to the goddamn ground. Like most shitty cryptocurrencies with no utility, their falls from graces typically average around between 99% losses to 100%, okay? That's just what we're looking at. Just remember, like, 95% of the NFT market is currently sitting at nearly 100% loss, okay? Crypto, and especially things that don't have proper utility, are not things that have longevity, okay? People compare cryptocurrency to the future of actual money. The reality is, real currency like a US dollar actually has value in that I exchange it for goods and services. Crypto is just there as a speculative asset that people hope will 100x. I don't exchange currency hoping that it 100x's. I use it to actually, you know, exchange things for goods and services. But anyways, this isn't an economics lesson, okay? Now, Ben got salty over Atozi's video and decided to sue the guy for defamation, which, of course, one thing you have to understand is when you're suing somebody, a lot of it is money, okay? The reality is when you get sued, it's not so much if I'm in the right or if I'm in the wrong. There is a lot of money you have to spend on legal fees, paying lawyers by the hours, you know, hiring a goddamn firm. This is something that can drain your cash immediately. And Atozi was somebody that actually had to even consider talking to a realtor to put their house up for sale just so he could afford to fight this lawsuit that Bennett put upon him. So for instance, he even says, when you hit me with your slap lawsuit, I had to call my real estate agent to discuss selling my house I was planning on bringing my firstborn to just days before you served me. I additionally launched a GoFundMe to help fight this, and you laughed at me for raising funds. When I raised more than I ever could, imagine your response was to instantly pull out and said on stream, well, now he has the funds. So immediately it showed that Bitboy didn't have a case. He literally tried to financially bully somebody smaller than him into basically giving up and eating their words. So Atozi raised around $200,000 in his GoFundMe, and Ben fucking freaked out. He's like, oh shit, this guy can actually fight a lawsuit. And Ben's entire case was a little bit self-reporty in terms of how he was giving out financial information and how he described his own channel. But of course, that's a whole different story. Let's get down even further. Now you might be like, but Muta, maybe that PAMP token was just a one-off. You know, everyone makes mistakes when they promote things. This is where Zach XBT, friend of the channel, a fellow crypto researcher, somebody that uncovers bullshit rug pulls on the internet, ended up creating an entire thread on our buddy BitBoy. So Zach XBT says, let's review all the direct scams BitBoy has worked with in the past. Just in case you forgot, here's the flyer with how much he charges. So what Zach did was he posed as a coin that was interested in promotion, reached out to the BitBoy team, and they provided him with like their media kit. The media kit that BitBoy has, this is how much money it costs for this dude to sell you out. Basically, for a dedicated review, he'll charge $35,000, a live stream mention is 20 racks, YouTube interview is 40 racks, and then, of course, website article is 2,500, and that's just how it is, okay? Ladies and gentlemen, BitBoy will sell you out for $35,000, all right? Just as a dedicated review. Now, that said, when we went down into the situation, what Zach did was he showcased a bunch of tokens that BitBoy had promoted, some of the evidence that he deleted, but obviously, Zach was archiving all of it. In fall 2020, BitBoy worked with MYX and even was warned by community members. BitBoy has since deleted that video. So you can see literally from BitBoy's articles, it's Tuesday, which means it's time for altcoin picks. As you guys know, Uniswap is on the move. That video is unreachable, okay? So that evidence is gone. And of course, MYX, much like PAMP, went up all the way here and immediately crashed down to fucking nothing. So here's one where BitBoy worked with Distex, a video he titled My Most Trusted Coin. One of these videos is actually still up on the channel, New Crypto Coin with 1000x Potential, as of this recording. So in this video, he promotes Distex, talks about it a little bit, and of course, he even tweets it. Check out Distex, their pre-sale crushed it. And of course, that entire plan failed. Distex died off, and it seems like the project was exit scammed. Now, of course, Zach actually says that there was no promotional disclosure. I don't know if he was actually being promoted, but if he was and he wasn't disclosing it, that's wrong. That's very wrong. Then, of course, there was even more situations. We have Zao Finance, another project that exit scammed in fall 2020. He deleted the tweet, but don't worry, I recovered it. So here he actually says, Zao Finance, we build a decentralized finance application. First fully women-empowered decentralized finance project. He actually put hashtag ad on here, which is at least a marketable improvement. Zao ended up being an exit scam. So ladies and gentlemen, we're just adding on. And of course, this list doesn't stop, okay? He just keeps going on, all right? In fact, it seems like if it's anything that is very evident with BitBoy, he does very little to investigate. This is somebody that has actual knowledge, self-admitted knowledge on the blockchain. How is this asshole not able to spot all of these blatant exit scams? And this is where, honestly, I want to kind of blame YouTube for this too. YouTube needs to do better. Like, honestly, you should terminate channels like this. Channels that make their bread on basically shilling out these kind of coins. Because we all know what's happening. People buy these coins, they become part of this project, and they end up losing their cash. One of the reasons why BitBoy is actually very negligent to the point where he should be investigated by law enforcement is that even if you're an influencer, because the way that this works is a lot of these coin guys will come up and give you money, right? Like, let's say that I was a crypto influencer, right? Let's say that Askcoin, right, tomorrow came up to me and said, hey, Muta, here's $40,000, okay? Make a video on Askcoin. So what I do is I take $40,000 as sort of like a ad rate, right? Like I just basically say, okay, sure, give me $40,000, I'll promote your product. It's like an ad for me, okay? It's a sponsored video. So I make $40,000. Now I push that project onto you. You guys end up putting in $80,000 into this coin, okay? So all of a sudden, 80,000 coins has entered liquidity. And what happens are these scammers who run this project immediately look at the 80,000, pull that liquidity out, and they run away with the token. So what happens is the price of the token goes from like a dollar, for instance, all the way down to like a penny, drops 99%, and there's nothing you can do because you can't swap it for actual valuable tokens. You are literally sitting there holding a bag. Now I, as the influencer, can say, oh my God, I didn't expect it, guys. I was lied to. I still made $40,000. You lost your money. The actual scammers made $40,000. I was just being paid off as the cost of business. So in a lot of cases, even if these people aren't necessarily behind the tokens, I actually say that there is some level, there should be, in my opinion, some level of responsibility on BitBoy's shoulders. He's making a bag while he's shilling actual dangerous financial shitcoins onto his audience. Now, what's really funny about it is, like, BitBoy has this thing where he tried to be the moral arbiter. So during FTX's collapse, Sam Bankman-Fried, the ex-CEO of that shitty exchange, what happened was BitBoy decided to go up and become the moral arbiter, shitting on Sam Bankman-Fried, right? Basically, you know, almost claiming to be one of the people that was responsible for his takedown, even though CoffeeZilla, friend of the show, did a lot more effort into doing that. In fact, if anybody should have their name attributed to the actual takedown of FTX, at least in the journalistic sphere, should be Steven, okay? Should be Coffee. In fact, what was so wild was people had called him out for that Zach XBT thread publicly, and BitBoy's response was unhinged. Listen to this one.
No one needs it.
Show me an EDC and say that's evidence.
All right, let's go and see, right? So guys, we can just go and check all the evidence posted by Zach XB.
A thread from a year ago.
It doesn't matter whether it's a year ago, right?
Yeah, it doesn't matter if it's a year ago, dog. Evidence is evidence. There's no statute of limitations on this shit. Watch his response. It's unhinged.
Now, hold on. When you do
please
this...
go and check all the
On public stage, he starts calling this innocent lady a child molester out of nowhere, which is actually straight up defamatory. But what's so funny is he says, I'm just calling you this without any evidence. The Zach XBT thread has the screenshots, archive videos that prove your degeneracy, fucking Ben. Come on now. How is this? This guy could be like the perfect politician, honestly. BitBoy was also an influencer that was brought up on a class action lawsuit in regards to influencers promoting FTX's unregistered securities. So he was brought up as one of the principal influencers that was, you know, involved in this lawsuit alongside Brian Young, Graham Stephan, and Kevin Paffrath. So, ladies and gentlemen, what does Ben do in regards to this investigation? Well, Ben goes kind of unhinged and starts shitting on the actual lawyer that's going up against him. And because of all of this, what Ben does is really wild. He actually misses a court date and sort of revolts against the system, even tweeting it out like, hey guys, I'm a degenerate. And by the way, State Casino is sponsoring my degeneracy as well too. This guy is seriously an unhinged, egomaniacal douchebag. Now, in the time that Ben's company has taken over the BitBoy crypto and kicked him out, basically of his own YouTube channel, Ben has had to jump into e-begging. So let's actually witness the little e-begging for his court case, where he wants to take back his YouTube channel. Listen to this one. Inside here, he says, the fact is, Hit Network has taken all my money from me, so I can't fight. I'm humbly asking anyone who has ever benefited from my content or anything I've done to donate to my legal fund to get BitBoy crypto back. Watch this.
Hey guys, I've been pretty absent lately, and I think if you read this thread here, you'll understand why. There's a lot going on here beneath the surface that people can't see. What Hit Network has done to me over the last 4 to 5 weeks. And people, there's no way the employees know that this has happened. And I think it's been easy for a lot of people to turn on me.
It's not easy for people to just turn on you, buddy. You have a history of killing your own credibility, okay? Turning on you is very, very easy. Come on now.
The fact is, guys, is my life has been on the line here. I have absolutely been given death threats from real credible people who claim that they've done it before.
Death threats are never okay, all right, to anybody. All right, that should be completely vilified in the community, 100%. Also, Ben, please provide actual screenshots of said death threats, okay? Just add validity to the video.
And if you look at, when I made the video, walking back some of the stuff that I said, because my life was on the line, go watch that video, you can see it. Just go watch the video. Guys, I've been under threat of blackmail. I've been extorted for my Lamborghini. That's gone. I've been under...
Aw, you lost the Lamborghini? Aw. Oh, man. I'm going to try giving a fuck. I really am going to try. I'm going to try, Ben, for you, buddy.
And the fact is I was under duress. And I've been under duress, guys. Like, when people see what they did to me with this Lamborghini, trying to bleed me out, that's what they're trying to do. They're trying to bleed me out of money so I can't fight.
Just like you did to a Tozy? Just like you tried to financially intimidate somebody? Aw. You know, it's really hard for me to care. Normally I don't enjoy the downfall of people, but when it comes to scumbags like this, boy, I'm a little hard right now, I ain't gonna lie. You know, I don't believe in karma or any of that shit, but goddamn, if there was a shining example for what karma is, it's this right here.
And so today, as I, put $20 in my gas tank earlier that I had to borrow from someone because I've been 100% cut off from all my money. My wife's American Express card, well, that wasn't paid for the last month. That wasn't paid. It was supposed to be getting paid by people that work for me, and they didn't do it. So the credit card's maxed out. And guys, we're in a tough spot here because they're trying to make me stop fighting.
Yeah, buddy, I don't care. So anyways, he puts up this giant facade of like, guys, they're taking away my money and I need to be able to fight back. So again, looking at Ben's remainder of the post, he's basically said, I'll speak more about it on stream tomorrow, 11:30 a.m. Eastern on my new channel, Ben Armstrong Crypto. What I've been through is the most traumatic experience of my life. My own friends and full-blood family members have turned on me over money. We filed a lawsuit. Hit Network sent me a death threat, which I have the police report for. Why don't you just post it? You've been posting everything so far. Come on now. So here's Ben's channel, new channel, folks. All right, you go to his videos here real quick. He's got like four videos. One of them is BitBoy is dead. It's official. Now in the thumbnail for this video, he showcases this like Rolex, which people have said is like $350,000. Don't know where that figure was pulled out of, but it is a Rolly, okay? It is an asset. Why are you begging for money? Sell your house. That seems like a nice house in the thumbnail. Start selling your assets. Sell the Lamborghini, sell all the cars, sell all the houses, downsize, sell the Rolex, do something. Ladies and gentlemen, why would you give a self-admitted millionaire money to fight a legal battle? This guy has a legal team, allegedly. This guy has some money. Even if he's 100% cut off, he's got to have credit at least. He's got to have some good financial credit. Let him dig himself out of this hole. But it's not that simple, ladies and gentlemen, because I'll be honest, it's not just Ben that's the problem. It's the crypto community itself that is the problem. Now, I wanted to look at Ben's wallet address, and it was a bit disturbing because Ben's apparently made $62,000 in just Ethereum alone. I looked at his Bitcoin wallet address, and let's just say he's made $100,000 in donations. So I wanted to actually throw this into BitQuery to just examine who was sending him money. And the largest sender was $41,000, which came from OX4A500. OX4A500 is a contract address for something known as the BitBoy Fund. Now, I looked more into the BitBoy Fund, 649 holders, and ladies and gentlemen, this was made like a day, 6 hours ago. So I assume this is like a contract address, like a special contract just to help set up this donation drive fund, which I'm honestly wondering, how is this so effective? You know, looking into BitBoy's channel, it's not a lot of people, like not a lot of actual traffic, at least in comparison to the amount of money that he's earned in this lawsuit. Of course, some of the other larger accounts that were actually trading money was OX9136451, to the tune of $8,000, an account known as Ben.eth, an NFT influencer who Ben used to work with before they had a falling out, because apparently they were cashing in on the highs of like meme tokens. Like anytime Elon would tweet out Pepe, they would make like Pepe coin or PSYOP. They would make PSYOP coin. Every time Elon would tweet something, they would just make a meme currency, and it would skyrocket to the moon. Cryptocurrency is truly just a degenerate platform. Now, I, on a personal level, question just the validity of some of these transactions. I'm not going to say there's anything illegal. There's no proof or anything like that, too. But for the amount of money that Ben makes, he's obviously getting, like, really bullied, too. There have been other accounts that are putting in, like, bullshit coins, like Dopecoin, Kekcoin, Bitboy coin is in here. You've also got things like Coke coin, you know, hinting at his, like, Coke addiction, if you will, too. Which, by the way, addiction is really fucked up. I'm not trying to make a joke out of it. Clearly, his fan base or some of the people like, hey, who hate him, don't think of that. You've also got fake token, cum lover. God damn. But at the end of the day, ladies and gentlemen, one thing is for sure in regards to BitBoy is, again, if you wanted to talk about karma, clearly karma doesn't exist. This man, you know, on a real level, on a personal level, given how he's, like, basically shilled nonsense to his fans, I really hope there's a world where he loses these lawsuits, loses everything that he has, the house, the Lamborghini. I want BitBoy to work at, like, Walmart or McDonald's or something, really humble himself. BitBoy is one of the biggest scumbags on the platform, and there's not much anybody can say other than, if you are somebody who watches crypto influencers, never take financial advice from anybody. And honestly, the only solace you can take right here is his channel has been hijacked by other scumbags that he worked with. Ladies and gentlemen, this is truly scumbag on scumbag violence. And honestly, I'm just here to laugh at the misfortunes of a true YouTube degenerate, which I think most of us should. Ladies and gentlemen, Ben Armstrong, BitBoy Crypto, is a scumbag. Somebody that you should stay far, far away from. And on a personal level, I really wish this person did get humbled. And honestly, I wouldn't even shed a tear if he truly lost everything that ever mattered to him in life. And that's because when it comes to financial advice on the internet, it really does cause serious damage. You know, I don't joke about it. Anytime I cover things like crypto scams or like finance scams, one of the scariest things to read is when you go to a subreddit for any of these crypto projects that have rug pulled or scammed people, one of the first posts is always suicide awareness. And that's because when somebody loses all of their money because they followed what some influencer says, yes, there is a degree of personal responsibility. But when your bag is being made off of the backs and livelihoods of others, and you could potentially send them into a hissy fit, like you could send them into like a suicidal fit, send them into a place where they can't claw themselves out of, then you, my friend, have blood on your hands. And I wouldn't doubt that BitBoy is responsible for a lot of bad misfortunes that have been kicked off. BitBoy's advice, stuff that he promotes so recklessly, should be monitored by YouTube, should absolutely be monitored by the law enforcement agencies around us. Ladies and gentlemen, this is me, Mudahar. Not much more to say. I think this video is long enough. If you like what you saw, please like, comment, and subscribe. Dislike if you dislike it. I am out.